It's the Melchizedek News Hour. It's the Melchizedek News Hour.
Shalom, family. Come on in. Come on in. Come on in. Shabbat shalom, everyone.
It's the Melchizedek News Hour.
Come on in, family. That in the live chat. I see you. Shalom, shalom, family. Come on in to the Melchizedek News Hour. Shabbat shalom on this Friday, April 12th. Come on in. Yeah, come on in, come on in, come on in. We got a lot to talk about. We got a lot to talk about. Come on in to the Melchizedek News Hour. I see you there, Brother Yosef. Yosef the elect, my significant other. Thank you for always holding me down. Who else do we got in the live chat? Thank you for joining, Sister Chayah. I see you, Sister Ola. Thank you so much. Love you so much. Thank you for always joining and holding down the channel. Saw that. Shouts out to the Most High Ministry. Thank you for joining the Melchizedek News Hour. Let's get into some headlines, y'all. It's a lot going on. But first, I want to say Shabbat Shalom. All praises to the Most High. For this is the Melchizedek News Hour. That's right, the channel that represents for the King of Kings, the King of Kings, our true Messiah, who is Motsah the Lamb, Yeshua, Yeshaya, Jesus Christ. He has many names among people, but, you know, all that matters is that you call him, because according to our tradition, beliefs, bring-ups, you know, backgrounds, he may have another name. But as long as you know where your strength comes from, amen, we must all come together in unity. Quit all this bickering about names and all those things, right? Yes, people bickering about names, and then they can't love their brethren and can't forgive they family, you know, they friends. Yeah. What's really the most important is truly the gospel of Yeshua. That's right. The gospel of the Lamb. Shalom there over there on Instagram. I see you. Matter of fact, I see my family in there. Omar, how's it going? My Midwest family. Shabbat shalom to you, my brother. All praises to the Most High. He's worthy to be praised. Good to see you. Good to see all of you. And if you're joining from Facebook, I appreciate you for coming over. That's right. So I'm going to put up my credentials so you know where to find Sister Chayah. That's right. Put them up. On Facebook, you can find me at Chayah Yisrael. That's right. I see some of you all are joining me from Facebook. And if it's your first time, I want to say welcome to the Melchizedek News Hour. And I appreciate you. Also on YouTube, I'm at Chayah the Elect. That's right. That's who's in front of you. You can find me on X, formerly known as Twitter, at Melchizedek News with a Z. And also on TikTok at Chayah the Elect. And I'm also on Instagram, Melchizedek_news. There you go. My credentials. Follow me. Subscribe if you haven't subscribed to my channel. We have fun over here at the Melchizedek News. We have fun. We get edification. I give you a lot of encouragement. If you're feeling like, you know, you've been defeated, this world is just tearing, because there's a lot going on right now. If this world is just tearing you down and got you frustrated and stressed and feeling hopeless, I'm here to give you some hope, brothers and sisters. That's why I do this channel. That's right. I use this platform to encourage you, to show you some love, to let you know that, yes, we're in a critical time, but you can make it through. As long as you know where your strength comes from, for Christ says, I can do all things through Christ that strengthened me. Amen. Who's in the live chat? Wants to conversate? I see you there, Sister Ruette. I hope you're doing well on this Friday. We got a lot going on in the weather. There's a lot developing just around the world in general. So I'm going to hop immediately into these headlines, because as I got on today to do this live, and you know I'm broadcasting from Hawaii. I see you there, Kings and Queens Coaching. Shalom, family. Shalom. As I came on, and I'm in Hawaii, so it's still, you know, in the a.m. I'm just at 11 a.m. here in Hawaii. But many things are popping off, not just with the weather, but overseas, the war drums. That's right. Wars in diverse places, earthquakes, everything. Is so much going on. So I'm gonna get y'all up to date on what's going on with Iran and Israel, because they over there popping it off. They popping it off, y'all. It's about to go down. I'm telling y'all that that solar eclipse came through. At least they so-called solar eclipse came through. For those of you that missed my lesson the other day, it was a powerful lesson I did about this group right here. NASA, yeah, them right there. They got people, you know, deceived in the world. You see that serpent tongue? That's because that word NASA means to deceive. It means deception in the Hebrew tongue. And they doing a whole lot of that right now, y'all. Man, they had everybody going on Monday with their sun worship. They had a big ritual. And ever since then, it's been popping off. It was already, you know, popping off, but I'm talking about it's popping, 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 popping like Jiffy popcorn. Yeah, that's what's going on. Real. Sister Ola said, for real, for real. Shalom there, Brother Scorpio. It's good to see you. You were there for the message that I did the other day about NASA. Yeah, who represents woohoo, that one right there. Satan. Yeah, I was exposing the other day, and I was just all tearing up they, you know, the darkness and all the lies, because they doing all kind of stuff in this earth right now, and they got people deceived. But I know one thing, the weather is cutting up right now all over the country, and not just, you know, the U.S., because a lot of times we're just focused on what's going on in the Midwest. But y'all got to know it's many things. Let me get my camera over here. It's many things going on all around the world, not just the Midwest. Amen. So I see you there, Brother Daryl. What's going on, Brother Daryl? It's good to see you. Yes. I'm trying to get my chair right for my camera, y'all. Let me scoot this over. There I go. Brother Daryl, I don't know if, yeah, you caught the message. I think you were on there the other day when I did the message about NASA and how they're deceiving everyone. So I just wanted to bring that up because a lot of people miss that, and it's a lot of deception. Under the description of my video today, particularly I have left a link, you all, to a very good video. Matter of fact, in the description, it says must watch. I want everybody to watch it. Look in the description of this video. You'll find the link to Lessons with Sistah Chayah. That's right, because, you know, I don't just do the news. Every now and then, I bring some edification and some wisdom, some spiritual wisdom for us. As a matter of fact, I got some at the end of this news today. So I'm going to keep y'all encouraged. But also, I do story time with Sistah Chayah for those people that just like somebody to read the word to them, and they just like the audio version. I got that for you, too. But I want y'all to see, there's a link. It says must watch. It's not on YouTube. It's on Rumble, because you know YouTube, they be limited on what they'll let you bring out to the people. So you can catch it on Rumble, and there's a link under the description. Let's get into the headlines, because we got a lot developing. I want to talk about what's going on over there in the Middle East right now as soon as I got on. I mean, I'm talking about updates, because that Iron Dome right now that Israel have, Iran is keeping them very, very busy. They trying to crack through that, okay? Y'all need to understand it's going down this weekend, and all that's going to affect everywhere around the earth, okay? Everywhere, especially in America, because a lot of people don't know this is a proxy war. Oh, yeah, baby. This the U.S. They might have on some Ukrainian uniforms over there. This the U.S. Yeah, Israel, Iran, Hamas, everything that's going on is affecting America. This is a proxy war. Yeah, they're trying to fake out the people. So I'm going to put up the information and the headline about what's going on over there. Give me 1 second, family. Check this out. Got this update this morning.
Overseas now to the Middle East, and growing concerns that Iran is preparing to attack Israel with some sort of military action. Our foreign correspondent Britt Klenet is on the scene in Tel Aviv. Good morning, Britt.
Good morning, Rebecca. Yeah, the U.S. Embassy in Israel is telling its staff here to stay put in cities amid an imminent threat from Iran that it will retaliate for last week's deadly strike on its consulate in Syria. American embassy staff and their families are now restricted from leaving Greater Jerusalem, Tel Aviv, or Be'er Sheva out of an abundance of caution, the embassy said. Now, U.S. officials have been working to deter Iran from a strike on Israel, with U.S. Central Command General Michael Carrilla in the region to coordinate on this threat, and Defense Secretary Lloyd Austin assuring his counterpart that Israel can count on full U.S. support to defend Israel against attacks from Iran, and Israel making it clear it will hit back if there is a strike on its territory. It would be Iran's first ever direct attack on Israeli soil. George.
Okay, Britt.
Mm-mm. They was talking cocky with it. She said, and Israel will strike back. Yeah, y'all better hope that dome holds up over there in Israel. Yeah. Because when I got online, it was going down. And I definitely see that it's going down over the weekend, because things are really escalating. You know what I was thinking, family? It's interesting how, you know, we had this total solar eclipse on Monday, and then all of a sudden the weather, especially in the U.S., just became really severe in a lot of places, because the South, Louisiana, Alabama, Mississippi, Kentucky, and Southeast, they got hit up big time over the last few days with like storms, flooding, tornadoes. And I'm thinking, like, you know, this is a way for this group right here. Yeah, that group right there with their technology and their power to keep everybody distracted from this war that's going on over in the Middle East, because it is going on. You know, I'll tell people the war started in 2019 when they got everybody to take the play injection, when they got everybody to drink the Kool-Aid. Yeah, that's when it really went down. But right now, they're keeping everybody distracted with the weather. So let's talk about the weather, shall we?
With each day just beginning with, unfortunately, more violence, so we want to already recap what we saw. And I know that you were here basically while this was going on, and We kept you busy, that's for sure.
Yeah, yeah. I was here on kind of the tail end of it yesterday. Right. In fact, we even watched the last couple of storms that kind of died down in Florida. But that line of storms, I mean, it was going on for several days straight. You could argue there were several different bow echoes that formed. Mm-hmm. But the bottom line is it spanned all the way from Texas to Florida. That entire northern Gulf Coast.
Look at some of these lines. That one was, to me, most impressive. That was, you know, on Wednesday. You'll remember that one, especially right along the I-10 corridor.
Yes.
And in total, by the way, in just 3 days, we saw, 20 tornadoes, 9, you know, across parts of Texas, Louisiana, Mississippi. On Wednesday, when we had that big, giant, almost like an MCS that moved.
Yeah.
It's a fancy way of saying a mesoscale convective.
Tell them what it is.
they rambling too much. While this weather is severe and destroying people's homes and their businesses and cars, everything is being destroyed right now. And they over there being jokey at Fox Weather, you know, like, oh, this is nothing. When people hold livelihoods and lives are being turned upside down, you see how the world do? They think it's a game. They think it's a joke. I got a comment from the live chat from Brother Yosef. He says, we have Israel's military back. But you best believe that Russia and China is with Iran. Yeah, you heard. Yeah, that's what's really going down. Yeah. Because the word of God has already stated what's going to happen while these rumors of war and all this is going down. I got something for y'all just because we aren't talking about this situation. Sister Ola said, but they talking about OJ, right? OJ Simpson passing away. Okay, it's a lot of people, not just OJ Simpson, right, sis? Passing away. And a lot of them is passing away from this cancer suddenly. Isn't it interesting how this cancer, everybody right now is getting diagnosed with cancer, passing away, dying suddenly, cancer, blood clots, strokes, heart attacks, everybody coming up with all kind of sicknesses and illnesses. What's the common denominator? Yeah, the planjection. That's Sister Chaya's name for it, the planjection. Because they planned all of that. You better wake up, people. I'm here to tell you, I'm your sister. I love you, and I'm going to tell you what the Word of God says. All praises to the Most High. I got something. Brother Yosef, you had mentioned about America having Israel's back. I went into the Word of God, and I'm reading from the sealed portion. I'll pull out the cover so people know the book. But it's something that I wanted to read that I have been thinking about for quite some time in the Word of God, coming from the Third Testament. No, actually, this is coming from the sealed portion. Pardon me. The sealed portion. And this is coming from chapter 71. I want to read something. Let me grab my book, though, so y'all know. Let me grab one of those that I'm reading from, so you know what I'm reading from. Because I do realize there are sometimes people that are new to my channel. This is the final testament of Jesus Christ. See that? Yeah. You thought your Bible was thick. That's the dictionary, right? The sealed portion. The final testament. You need to get that from Amazon if you want to elevate your walk with the Most High and find out all the lies and the things that they kept out of your Bible, because the Bible does not have all of the gospel of the Most High. Okay? The Most High left us much word, and it's not all in the Bible. As a matter of fact, wicked men have had their hands all in the Bible, and they've corrupted quite a bit. So the Bible can definitely be used as a weapon against us if you really do not know the true words of the Messiah. So there, I said it, and it is the truth. The sealed portion, I'm going to give you something because a lot of people don't understand what's going on because this war is really intensifying. I'm going to read from the sealed portion, chapter 71, and I'm going to start at 68. And I'm just going to read this, and I want you to think about what's going on in the Middle East, family. And the 10 horns which thou saw are the 10 kings, which have received no kingdom as yet, but they receive power as kings for 1 hour with the beast. These have one mind. Look at that. These have one mind and shall give their power and strength to the beast. And these things have I already given an explanation previously in this record. But these are the words of John that I have not yet explained to you. And he wrote saying that these shall make war with the Lamb. And the Lamb shall overcome them at the last day, definitely. For he is the Lord of lords and the King of kings, and they that are with him are called chosen and faithful. Absolutely. All praises to the Most High, for this is the Melchizedek News Hour. And he said unto me, the waters which thou sawest, the waters that you saw where the whore sits are the people. Listen to that. Where the whore sits are the people and the multitudes and the nations and tongues. And the 10 horns which you saw upon the beast, these, he said, shall hate the whore. Okay? And shall make her desolate and naked. Speaking in symbolism and code here. Shall make her desolate and naked and shall eat her flesh and burn her with fire. For God has put in their hearts to fulfill his will and to agree and to give their kingdom to the beast until the words of God shall be filled. And the woman which you saw is the great city which reigns over the kings of the earth. We're talking about elite societies and wicked men running the earth. This is what John was speaking of in Revelation. And that Bible has many codes and symbolism and metaphor on it. So a lot of people don't know that Hasatan, Lucifer, Satan is using this Bible as a weapon, because many people are ignorant to the understanding of particularly the book of Revelation that talks about these last days and talks about war. And so what you see is these nations going against each other. But who? Those that used to be friends and allies and doing all kind of corrupt business behind closed doors. Oh, yeah. Yeah, they in bed together and they're going to betray each other. That's what they're doing right now. They were doing business together, making all kind of money, you know, behind closed doors. But now they done backstabbed each other. That's what we're seeing, people. That's what's playing out. They backstabbing each other. And the word of God has put it out. Yeah, because it's all going to come together for his plan. Y'all better understand, for his plan. And in the meantime, they playing the people like they just did with their big sun worship. Mm-hmm. The solar eclipse was all about sun worship. They put a lot of excitement, fear, energy into the air so Satan can garner all that energy. Oh, yeah, they love to just collect everybody's energy. Y'all better wake up. It's a lot going on. This group right here, that's one of his main groups. Yeah, I exposed him very good on that lesson I did. The world is given into the hands of the wicked. It says the entire world is given into the hands of the wicked, and he covers the faces of the judges. Yes, Satan is doing a lot of deception in this hour. You better recognize. Sister Ola has a comment, and she said, 2024, the year of truth and recompense. Man, I'm going to have to keep that posted all during the show. Good one. Absolutely it is, sis. All right, let's go into some more headlines, because they're popping it off and it's going to intensify this weekend. And you better believe that everything that's happening overseas in the Middle East is going to affect America. Not to mention, we got this big situation with the immigrants coming over across the border, you know, of women and children mixed in with a few, like, sales, a few demonic sales. You know what I'm saying? That they giving money and some weapons to. Yeah. All in strategic places, just waiting on that phone call. It's time to wake up, family, because your faith needs to be in the Most High, because that's all we got right now. He's all we got and he's all we need. You heard it. He's all we got and he's all we need. But it's time to get into the spiritual ark. And my brothers and sisters, I love, they've been saying, get into the barn. That's right. All praises to the Most High. Get into the spiritual barn. Okay, let's go next and get an update on the weather. because we know all that. Another update. It was flooding yesterday over there in Pittsburgh. We already heard she said it's going to be tornado outbreaks, but anybody see the footage?
Contending with wind advisories, we showed you the flood watches at the top of the hour. And with both of these things in mind, power outages, airport delays are going to be possible. In New Hampshire and Maine, we've got that deeper snowpack. So that's in place, and that's leading to a combination of, well, snowmelt and heavy rain to some flooding. And that's the trend that we've been seeing. So overall, as we're taking a look right now in Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, we're looking at some of that rain that we experienced overnight the past 24 hours. And while earlier in the month of April, Pittsburgh was the focus of some very heavy rain, we eclipsed that yesterday.
Look at that. All that flooding going on. Alabama, Louisiana, Pittsburgh. Show some more.
And, you know, right now it looks to be Monday night for Oklahoma City. That could wiggle a little bit, but an early indication, I mean, gosh, if we have overnight storms on Monday, an overnight tornado threat's always terrifying.
Yep. And we've got 3 days to get the juice up there. So 3 days, starting today, Saturday and Sunday, all that humidity is going to come out of the Gulf.
And it's already starting. I mean, gosh, today we get into the 70s in Kansas.
Yeah, and then we're going to see temperatures into the upper 80s by Saturday, and even near 90 when you get to Oklahoma and parts of Kansas by Sunday into early Monday. So that's what we're watching, that heat going through. We've got the dry line also. So the dry line separates that drier continental air would be off to the west with that Gulf moisture and all the fuel that's off to the east. That line itself, that brown line right there, that can really fuel some big thunderstorms as well. You add on top of that the upper-level jet stream that's going to be pulling in, energy out of the Rocky Mountains, and it's all going to come into fruition, all phased together to get severe thunderstorms rocking and rolling by probably late Saturday afternoon or Monday afternoon, but it looks more like Monday evening when these things initiate and then roll right through Oklahoma into Kansas, Texas as well, and those are the classic supercells.
Family, that's weather that they're projecting for next week. They're talking about over the weekend. And I saw Oklahoma. I got family and friends there. I saw a big portion of Texas, a number of states. They're saying, get ready for next week. Like Brother Yosef just said in the chat, you hear them? We eclipse them. They know what they're doing. It's time for us to wake up. This is a time to be praying. If you're not praying right now, you need to be. You need to be. And not only just praying, but you need to be obedient. Because what's the sense of praying if you're not going to walk into obedience of the Most High? That means those prayers are falling on deaf ears. There's no action behind that. Because the Word of God says faith without works is dead. Meaning it's not void. It doesn't. What does it add up to? Got to have some action behind that. Oh, praises to the Most High. This weather situation is getting very intense. I'm just going to give those in the chat and those that are watching a heads up. Next week looks very catastrophic for a number of states. They're already lining this situation up. I truly believe that the day that they did their big sun worship ritual in the earth, particularly during that, you know, big solar eclipse on the path of totality, CERN was operating, and the goal was to open a portal, to open a demonic portal. Many people don't know what that is. Well, if that's okay. You don't know. You're about to see. Yes, Sister Ola has a comment. Says the prayers of disobedient are an abomination to the Most High. You got to come correct with the Most High. What's the sense if you're praying? Praying, that's right, because prayer is the action. And the Word of God says the attitude of prayer is obedience. I'll get that in my seal portion. Let me grab that out. Absolutely, Sister Ola, seal portion, chapter. What you got, Sister Chaya? What you got? Because that's my favorite. One of my favorite ones is chapter 23, I believe. Let's get it. I just want to read that because I know a lot of people, you may have not heard these things. Shalom, pursue righteousness, real love, real respect. That's the hashtag for those of you that are joining my channel for the first time. My hashtag is RLRR. It stands for Real Love, Real Respect. If you see it anywhere on the social media platforms, think about Sister Chaya and think about your Father, the Most High, because he's all about real love and real respect. In the sealed portion, chapter 22, it says, 58 says, and obedience is the attitude of prayer. Look at that. And obedience is the attitude of prayer. For it is by obedience that we obtain the Spirit. What Spirit? The Holy Spirit, the Spirit of our Father. And it is by this Spirit that we receive all things which we need to be happy. Look at that, which we need to be happy. And the thing that shall make us happy is the fruit of the Spirit. What's the fruit of the Spirit? You got to do good works in order to get that peace, that joy, that gentleness, especially peace right now with everything that's going on. You got to be in obedience with the Most High. And what was the number one way to be in obedience? Is the most important commandment is do unto others as you would have others do unto you. That's right. Love thy neighbor. Love your enemies. Even those you don't understand, those you don't agree with, love them. You got to purge their hearts, sisters and brothers. It's time to unify family. That's what this channel was all about. I'm here to bring all together, no matter what your beliefs are, your religion, your traditions, your customs, your politics, your beliefs. Doesn't matter. It really doesn't matter. Because if you ain't leading in love and walking in love, you could throw all that out the window. All right, let's go to the next headline here because I want y'all to see something. As Brother Yosef said in the live chat, he said, listen to what they say. You got to listen. Close your eyes and listen to what these satanic people are saying. Why do they have William Shatner, Captain Kirk? And I brought some of this out when I did the news yesterday. But for those that were yesterday were present, I deleted that. I had to come again. Because I was not feeling the news yesterday. It was so doom and gloom. I had to, it was like, reboot. She came again. But I want y'all to hear, why would they go to Captain Kirk from what? Star Trek? It's people that don't even know who that is. And talk to him about the eclipse. I want y'all to listen with your ears to what this satanic mind is saying. He's trying to tell y'all something. This was went down on Monday.
Your home for complete coverage of Indiana's total solar eclipse.
Well, we are just under 2 weeks away from the solar eclipse making its way across central Indiana. Former Star Trek star William Shatner will be making an appearance in Bloomington as part of Indiana University's festivities. Shatner will be doing a spoken word performance. Well, today he told News 8 he doesn't know what to expect when the eclipse happens.
It's perfectly probable that there'll be an enormous thunderstorm the instant the sun is eclipsed. It's also perfectly possible that it'll be a clear, bright, lovely, warm spring day, and we will all enjoy the benefits of the Hoosier weather. What happens if it's cloudy? I don't know. It's like looking into the pit of a volcano saying, what do we do about that thing? And there's nothing can be done.
All right. Well, Shatner.
Did y'all hear that? Did y'all hear how cryptic he was sounding? Cryptic. Yeah. I want you to recognize who this is, why he over here trying to give us advice about the solar eclipse. Why are they talking to this man in the, this man, the Star Trek ain't been out in forever. Okay. I just want y'all to think about this stuff. Star Trek ain't been out in forever. This man, many people don't even know who this is. Okay. And why is he so important that they talking to him during the day of the solar eclipse? Who are these people? Just because they look like us, are they us? Listen to this man. But who is he?
I'm losing command. I'm losing the Enterprise. Ship is sailing on and on. I'm alone. Alone. I'm losing command. Captain, I've lost command. I've lost the Enterprise.
They didn't wait to Captain Kirk. They was like, we got to interview Captain Kirk. Yes, Sister Ola, we have love for all. But what I'm trying to really say, it's time for us to wake up and realize that everybody that's in this earth is not of the Most High. Yes, they may look like us, but they are not us. And once you really understand, matter of fact, that link that I included, woo, that musty link in my description of this video, please watch it so you can understand about them draconians, them vampires that's really here. Mm-hmm. We got a reptile society. Oh, they don't want me to bust it out. They might cut me off if I get to talking about it. Cut her off, cut her off. Yeah, because people don't know there's a lot of inner earth stuff going on. But anyway, we're not talking about that. That's just the news. Watch the link that I included in my description. Oh, it's a lot going on in this earth. All right, brothers and sisters. Meanwhile, we got all these storms. And I want to repeat this again. These insurance companies is cutting people's claims, denying people, shutting offices. We can't help y'all. If your house been flooded, there's a fire, whatever, tornado, State Farm finna shut down. I'm telling y'all, mark my words.
The devastation of wildfires in the western U.S. extending well beyond these charred remains, with people now losing the ability to insure their homes. California residents are scrambling after 72,000 property insurance policies were dropped by the state's largest home insurer, State Farm.
They pulled out of the state of California, and there's nothing we can do other than beg.
Jill Osborne lives in Sonoma County. While her home was not destroyed in a fire, it's one of thousands deemed high risk. She feels blindsided after losing insurance.
They say, like a good neighbor, State Farm is here. Well, they're certainly not here for us.
State Farm saying, in part, this decision was not made lightly, citing inflation, catastrophe exposure.
So I just wanted to share that with you all so we can see that these insurance companies, yeah, they're about to be shutting their doors. They're about to be cutting people. They're about to be denying claims. You see all these tornadoes and all this flooding going on in all these different cities? It's a lot going on. You think they're going to just be cutting checks? I've been asking everybody, think to yourself with everything you see right now. How does 12 months look from now? Really picture that. With the situation with immigration, all these countries, Europe, UK, everybody, Middle East, it's collapsing slowly in front of people. And they want to bury their heads in the sand like, oh, it's not happening. Meanwhile, we got this. We need to be concerned about a possible new lockdown because of this.
Tonight, the CDC with an urgent alert telling healthcare providers to be on the lookout for possible cases of bird flu. That's if they encounter sick patients who recently had contact with birds or livestock. One human case reported so far this year in the U.S., but officials say the risk to the public remains low. Here's ABC's M. Nguyen.
Tonight, the CDC warning healthcare workers and the general public about bird flu after a person in Texas tested positive this week in what is believed to be the first cattle-to-human transmission.
This avian flu has now shown up in cows for the first time and has now infected a farm worker. But overall, the risk to the public currently is low.
The virus, also known as H5N1, has been discovered in livestock across six states since March. And in birds across eight states in the past 30 days, according to the Department of Agriculture. Calmain Foods.
Eight states in the past 30 days. H1N1, avian bird flu, 100 times worse than COVID. We already have an infected case in Texas. Mm-hmm. And there's, matter of fact, what was that? Last weekend, I believe, they had to put down several million birds. There's your food resources, the people that, you know, still eat living creatures. But at the end of the day, there's our food resource. And that's been going on behind the backs of people for years now, them destroying the agriculture, the poultry, food plants, the water. It's a lot going on that people need to be paying attention to. All praises to the Most High. Do I got a comment in the live chat? Yes. Sister Ola says, yeah, bird flu just jumped species, but that's because they made it. They make every disease and virus, sis. Yeah, it's all in their labs. Every disease and virus has been created by wicked men. That's the truth. Brother Yosef says, me and family, get your house in order so you won't be caught unaware, begging the enemy for help. Absolutely. Because the last time that tornado, it was like several tornadoes, I remember a few months back. I seen so many people that looked like us. Not that this has anything to do with color, but it was so many copper colored folks in the line saying, help us. We just lost our houses in these tornadoes. It's going to get worse and worse. Nothing is about to get better. So people better get their spiritual house in order. Nothing's going back to normal, people. Nothing. If you've been waiting, I don't know how, when you're seeing all this demonic activity on the earth, like this young lady here, I want to talk about this situation. It really just hurt my heart. But I still got to talk about it.
A Los Angeles influencer who allegedly killed her boyfriend and daughter is at the center of a murder investigation. And police say the recent solar eclipse may have played a role in the tragedy. Danielle Johnson, who offered online self-help and healing sessions under the name Danielle Aoka, allegedly killed her partner in their Los Angeles home before pushing her two children out of a moving vehicle hours before the April 8th astrological event. The LAPD says in a press release. Law enforcement sources tell the Los Angeles Times that investigators believe the eclipse may have been a factor in their tragic deaths. In the early morning hours.
How was the eclipse a factor in her death? I mean, I know they were doing a satanic ritual, but the majority of the world doesn't know that because it just looked like all kind of excitement. You know, I brought the picture of this young lady out with this story because a lot of people don't understand sorcery and witchcraft. They think it's like the witch got to look like something spooky or something that you can, somebody that you can recognize. No. New age occult looks like what that young lady just looked like. Satan is cunning. He out here operating behind all kind of faces. Yeah, catching a lot of people off guard. What a sad situation. A young woman not only killed her 29-year-old baby father, threw her baby on the interstate over there in California, LA, 405, 8 months old, threw both of her kids. The 9-year-old survived. But the 8-month-old baby got hit on the freeway. What causes somebody? And then the girl, boom, ran her Porsche into a tree, killed herself. Nothing but demons. See, people think they can recognize evil, but you can't right now. Only if you got the Spirit of the Most High will He give you discernment to really see what's going on. I got a few comments in the chat. Sister Ola said, hurts her head. Brother Duro said she was into sorcery and astrology. And Brother Duro, absolutely. But people don't know how these people that are working in divine, you know, arts look like. They think like, oh, I'm a no. A lot of people saying they're prophetess and got all these labels and so forth, they're operating in divination. And people are so unaware because they're relying on the arms of flesh. They're relying on men and women to tell them things. I got a scripture on that. I wanted to talk about that. I'm glad I remembered because it was a scripture that I wanted to bring out. Let me get it out for you all. I wanted to bring out a scripture about divination because the Most High says, I don't need no middleman. And we keep thinking like He got to speak through people to speak to us. So it's something that I want to bring out. Give me 1 second, because I think it's really important. And that's what we do here on the Melchizedek News. This news is all about the Messiah. We don't do things like the regular news. We got to connect the scriptures and the prophecies to the things that are happening in the world, because there's a lot that's happening. There's a lot happening right now, and we got to connect it to the Word of God. So I'm going to pull up something, because a lot of people, right, found tarot cards. But even when people don't have tarot cards, that doesn't mean they're not working in witchcraft and sorcery. See, the thing is, Yisrael, the Most High's own people, they were operating in major witchcraft and sorcery. Yes, and he was trying to give them some wisdom and let them know. See, anytime when you go outside the Most High, then you're using mediums. I'm going to show you here in the Word. I'm going to go into Leviticus. There we go. Leviticus 19 and 31. I got it at the top of the screen. I'm going to read this. This is from the Old Testament. And a lot of people need to understand what the Most High's Word is trying to teach you, even in this hour, because the Word is the same yesterday, today, and forever. This is Old Testament in the book of Leviticus. It says, give no regard to mediums and familiar spirits. Do not seek after them. Amen. Do not, it says, to be defiled by them. I am the Lord your God. In Leviticus 20 and 6, he says, and the person who turns to mediums, yeah, that's a mediator, a middleman, a middle woman, and familiar spirits to prostitute himself with them. Because he's saying, I don't need a middle person. You don't have to go to another person. You don't have to rely on the arms of flesh. I speak and communicate to you through your spirit. It says, I will set my face against that person and cut him off from his people. So people need to understand what these scriptures are saying when you're reading them. This is scriptures from Old Testament Bible. Like I said, if you don't know this Bible, it can be used as a weapon against you. It could also be powerful if you have discernment in the true spirit of God to understand what he's saying. But clearly here in the Old Testament, in the book of Leviticus, he's saying, I don't need a medium. That's what a mediator, that's what a medium is. They're a mediator. The Most High says, I'm able to communicate with my children directly through your spirit because you are a living soul. I created you that way. You don't have to rely on a prophet, a prophetess, a counselor, a psychiatrist, a therapist, you know, none of them. NASA, a school teacher, none of it. You got to know this word for yourself, sisters and brothers. You got to know when you read these scriptures, what is he saying here? And the reason why I'm bringing this up is because, and Sister Ola said that too, bring it up in the chat. She said, even Solomon fell for this trap. Absolutely. That was at the fall. Yeah. Going to these middle people telling you God said this and he told me to tell you that you're going to be blessed in this way, or God told me to tell you. No, God did not tell you to tell me this, my sister. You don't know me. You don't know anything about me. You don't know my past. You don't know the tribulations I've been through. You don't know what I cry out to the Most High at night. Only he knows what's in my spirit. So can't nobody come telling you these things. I'm trying to make it clear to my brothers and sisters, because this young lady was making a lot of money on the internet, on social media, being a new age teacher, a mediator. But this same lady just killed her whole family and left her 9-year-old without a family. But when you look at her, she looked normal. She's an attractive woman. Wake up. Don't matter what people look like. Judge them by their fruit. Judge them by their actions. Judge them by what's coming out of their mouth. Compare what they're saying to this word of God. Are they preaching and living by this word? Are they speaking these things and living by them? That's the real sensitive this topic for me, because if so many people keep relying on the arms of flesh, relying on men and women to tell them things. I don't care if they have a label as a prophetess, bishop, pastor, prophet. You don't need any arm of flesh. Christ keeps telling us this. What are we not hearing? All right. That's enough, Sister Chai. That's enough. Let's talk about this particular case right here. We already, for those of you, I'm sure many people know this, but we'll put it up again because the rest of the world is talking about it, just so everybody knows.
We are following breaking news. This just coming into our newsroom. O.J. Simpson, the former football star who was accused of killing his ex-wife and her boyfriend, has died. His family sharing the news on social media. And I'm just going to read the statement here. On April 10th, our father, Renthal James Simpson, succumbed to his battle with cancer. This is the family's statement.
Cancer. cancer. I've never seen so much cancer, people. Never seen so much. Many of you may have family members and friends that have recently been diagnosed with cancer. This also happened. I want to bring this in again because I reported this yesterday before I had tugged down that particular segment from yesterday. But I just want people to be aware of this because I got an opinion on this too.
Tonight, gunfire erupting outside a Ramadan event in Philadelphia.
We got an active shooting going on at this time.
At least three people were shot near a mosque where police say an estimated 1,000 people were gathered to celebrate Eid, the end of the holy month.
They observed three males and a female running, and they stopped those individuals, and we recovered four weapons.
An officer firing at a fifth suspect, a 15-year-old male who was armed, according to police.
It was unexpected. Like, people were jumping tables, going up under trucks and stuff.
Look at that child. He was like, people was running under trucks and hiding, and they shooting the kids, just being all traumatized with the example that we're out here being. We're living in a very dark time. But what I would like to say about that situation right there is we need to practice some wisdom and critical thinking, some vigilance about, you know, being in public places. Right now is really a wise time to, like, lay low. Yeah. You know, I know people have their beliefs and they want to come together, but you need to be conscious about, hey, not everybody is in agreement about what you're believing and what you're coming together for, and you make yourself a target. It's really time to come into thy chamber. Yes, lay low. Yeah, sometimes it's just wise to do that. And this is that hour where you make yourself a victim or a family member a victim. Because it's just it's a very dark time, and you just got to use wisdom. Young women, you know, if you can get off work earlier, you know, even though I know things are happening during the day, but man, during the day is so much better than at night. Limit the time that you're out in the nighttime hours. You know, make wise decisions. Young men, it's just really that time. Yes, Brother Durrell, it's that time. We got to use wisdom. The Most High he's given us critical thinking, but we've thrown it out the window. You know, we've been really brainwashed with this really satanic system, a wicked system, and we're not using any type of logic in anything. So Sistah Chayah is here as your sister. I love you. I'm trying to give you help. Those that's listening and watching, I love you. This is why I'm so passionate and sincere about the things that I'm saying. I'm somebody who's went through tremendous trials and tribulations in my life. You know, I'm still going through things. I'm still healing from things, and I'm just trying to help you. You know, I talk in a great deal and with passion about this planjection, because that's what killed my 29-year-old son. And I, you know, I'm telling you facts. I got evidence that support that. Yeah, the certificate of death says that. I know these things. I'm trying to help you. And it's things that we can do to try to build our immune systems back up. I did a video and I put up some information about people that have taken this thing right here. You don't have to just be quiet and sit at home and be all in shame and feeling all in guilt about your actions. There's things that you can do to improve your immune system, you know, to try to reverse this thing. So I try to share that information with my brothers and sisters because I love you and I truly do. I'm going to go into this. I want y'all to understand what's going on out here since we're talking about it's so dark and it's satanic. This is a repeat. I brought this about a week ago, and I want to share to those that may be new to the channel. Once again, they're talking about this rare demon face syndrome. What is that really about, rare demon face syndrome?
Censored, here's the weird stuff I love. Imagine your vision is totally normal, and then one day you see demonic features everywhere on people only, just like this, what you see behind me. Now that's a reality for a man named Victor Shera. He has extremely rare yet terrifying disorder called PMO, and it's commonly known as, or now known, because people didn't know about it at first. It's called the demon face syndrome. People with the condition see parts of other people's faces distorted in shape, texture, position, or color. For Shera, that means grotesque, grimace, elongated eyes, and deeply etched scars, also pointed ears. There are 75 known.
What do y'all think that's really about? I have my thoughts about that situation right there. Rare demon face syndrome. You know, for some of us that are on alternative outlets where you can get information, a lot of people that have been passing away suddenly, they're seeing things before they pass away. Mm-hmm. There's all kind of video on alternative outlets where people, before they pass away suddenly, they're seeing things and they're fighting things away. I wonder what they're seeing. Maybe they're seeing what he just described. Rare demon face syndrome. Oh, they got a name for it? You see what I'm saying? This is in the news. It sounds like they're making excuses for things that are happening. I'm telling y'all, it's time to wake up. It's a lot happening. We got a precept in the live chat. Pursue Righteousness has Isaiah 26 and 20. Go, my people, enter into your rooms and shut your doors behind you. Hide for a little while until the wrath, that's right, is past. Yeah, sometimes you just got to come indoors. Sister Ola said, the photos look like Photoshop, but predictive programming and also prophecy is all spiritual. Absolutely. Because they're telling you what's really going on and what people really are seeing. They know what they did. And then think about it. If people are seeing these, what they call it, demon face syndrome, that may cause you to lash out. I see you all up there. What is that? X, formerly known as Twitter. You know, I try to share my information on Twitter, Mr. Elon Musk. But it seems like every time Sister Chayah goes live with the Melchizedek News, they be hating on me. And then it's not active. They'll like break my link that I include. We already know you don't like the Melchizedek News and you're totally against it. But you can't come against us because no weapon that is formed against me shall prosper. So this information and who I'm giving this information to, whoever it's for, and if it touches you, then it's for you. Whoever it's not for, it's not for you then. That's how I see it. So be it. All right, what we got next, Sister Chayah? What you got next? All right, I reported this yesterday for those that missed it because people are like, oh, bestiality, I didn't even know that exists. Oh, yeah, it's people out here having sex with animals. Yeah, demons.
And new at 10, an extremely disturbing story out of Spring tonight. It involves bestiality, possession of child pornography, and indecency with a child by exposure. This is KPRC 2 News at 10. I'm Keith Garvin.
Good evening. I'm Daniela Guzman. The Montgomery County Precinct 3 Constable's Office says the husband even committed some of his crimes inside of a busy supermarket. And that is where we find our Devin Clark tonight joining us to break down the disturbing details.
The charges stem from allegations that many would find appalling. Officials say some of those crimes happened within the confines of the suspect's home, but it wasn't until the husband brought his perversions here to this HEB that this all came to light.
Meet the Keens, this spring couple now looking at prison time, charged with felonies after investigators say they discovered the two had been engaging in lewd and illegal acts. It all starts here at this HEB on Rayford Road, where officials with the Montgomery County Precinct 3 Constable's Office say they were dispatched back on March 13. They say William King was following kids around inside the supermarket as he exposed and touched his genitals. During the course of the investigation, officials say they seized William King's phone and found not only child pornography, but also evidence of bestiality involving his wife. They say they found a video of Jolie King having sex with the couple's Great Dane dog. Today, they were both arrested at their home in the Harmony subdivision nearby.
Officials say they were not only able to rescue that abused Great Dane, but also two other dogs from the couple's home and say that they've prevented them from further sexual exploitation. Now, at last check, the couple was still inside of the Montgomery County Jail. Jolie King charged with bestiality and William King charged with...
Mm-hmm. You heard right. Great Dane. Next. I'm not even going to make a comment on that one. Next. This doctor over here need to be ashamed of himself This is why I'm reporting it. I know some of you that are in the live chat, you might have heard these couple of headlines yesterday, but I had to repeat it for those that missed out. So we got an anesthesiologist preparing surgery for people, and he over here corrupting and tainting the IV bags. Oh, my goodness. This is why I have to talk about
today,
this.
Today, jurors heard from the doctor who witnesses say first put the pieces together that IV bags were the source of multiple cardiac emergencies at a North Dallas surgical center. Good evening. I'm Clarice Tinsley. This is the fourth day of testimony in the trial of a doctor who prosecutors say was caught on camera putting tainted IV bags in a warmer, resulting in one death and a number of cardiac emergencies. Fox 4's Lori Brown reports.
We no longer felt a pulse. That is what Dr. Thomas Hung testified about the horrific events that unfolded during a simple surgery to repair Jack Adlerstein's nose after a bike accident. Hung said there were signs of fluid in his lungs. Someone suggested we change the IV bag, Dr. Hung testified, and in 1 minute, Jack's condition improved. That someone turned out to be anesthesiologist Dr. Chad Marsden.
No questions. Thank you so much.
Dr. Marsden testified how he came to the realization the IV bags could be behind a string of cardiac emergencies in patients at the center. August 19, 2022, a Friday, his patient, Kelly Pfeiffer, experienced skyrocketing blood pressure. And unlike any other case, he could not control it with medication. She was rushed to the ER. Dr. Marsden noticed that.
How do these people figure that they're going to get away with this kind of stuff? Y'all already know in the hospital, they got cameras everywhere in these hospitals. It's just like if you go to the Justice Center, there's cameras everywhere. And he over here corrupting and tainting the IV bags and got people all going into cardiac arrest. Man, folks is just evil. That's what I'm saying, y'all. Yeah, rare demon face. It ain't rare demon faces. Demons all around us. Oh, goodness. We got another one right here. Let's report this one.
13 tonight, a woman says she paid $8,000 for a cosmetic procedure that led to complications and regret. She said it was performed by a woman who was arrested alongside her daughter in an undercover illegal butt injection sting this week. ABC 13's Jessica Willey broke the story that people are talking about now all across the country. And Jessica, we're starting to learn more about the people who say they've been impacted by this.
Yeah, Brianna, since our story aired on Wednesday, four women have come forward calling Houston police with some horror stories. The two women we spoke to tonight say the mother has been injecting people for more than a decade. Neither she nor her daughter are licensed to practice medicine.
In 2022, this 32-year-old mother wanted some enhancements.
Just to get bigger butt, because that's what was going on. So I was like, I want to do it.
She said she got a referral from a friend, saw the work.
She showed me pictures of other girls, and she even said she travels to go do strippers. And
oh, my goodness. Women, quit messing with your bodies. Did y'all hear that one part? It said that this team, I guess mother and daughter, they've been doing this for over 10 years. Making all kind of illegal money, plumping up people's butts. Yeah, until somebody passed away. Oh, my goodness. It's crazy out here. What's this case? Report, Houston surgeon. Let's see what this one is. It's a lot of stuff going on in these medical offices and non-medical offices because they ain't even got no license or nothing. They just at the house just pumping up people's booties.
For joining us at 10, I'm Keith Garvin.
And I'm Daniela Guzman. The bombshell allegations first reported by the New York Times this evening in the wake of Memorial Hermann Hospital deactivating its liver and kidney transplant programs over the last week. KPRCG's Bryce Newberry live in West University Place tonight with what we know so far tonight. Bryce?
Daniela and Keith, tonight we have independently confirmed that this is a federal investigation involving the U.S. Department of Health and Human Services. That New York Times headline that a Memorial Hermann doctor is accused of secretly denying liver transplants came out around 6 o'clock this evening, and we have been trying to reach the doctor as well as the hospital ever since. We knocked at the listed address for the doctor just after the news broke. The lights were on and a dog came to the door, but no one answered. The New York Times report that transplant surgeon Dr. Steve Beinen manipulated a government database and made some of his own patients ineligible to receive new livers, potentially depriving them of life-saving care. Just last week, Memorial Hermann deactivated the liver transplant program, telling KPRC2 in a statement the hospital found out about a pattern of irregularities with donor acceptance criteria within the United Network for Organ Sharing Transplant Information Database for patients awaiting a liver transplant.
Do y'all see this corruption? I'm telling you what's going on. That is an important headline. You got a doctor, a world-renowned surgeon, who is manipulating the list and paperwork on who can get a liver or not. Scriptures talk about getting organ transplants and all that, and how that we would just be content with leaving here and going home with the Father in peace. These doctors is all about money. It's all about the coins with them. It's all about the coins. All of them, psychiatrists, doctors, surgeons, it's all about them coins. They all serving the beast. That number of the beast is that 666. That's money. It's money. Money. Even this situation, they talking about changes to people being able to live on the streets. I think this is out of California. Where else they gonna go then? They can't live on the streets? You know, really? Homelessness is so bad, but then now y'all can't live on the beat. You gotta take your car somewhere else.
Meantime, San Diego's rules for people living in their cars could change.
In fact, this comes after a lawsuit settled this year set new rules for how the city is allowed to enforce ordinances. Our Zara Barker is joining us live now with the latest on the settlement. Zara.
Kathleen and Phil, this has been nearly a seven-year-long legal battle, but the city of San Diego has reached a more than $3 million settlement. Now, we talked to some people impacted by this settlement. Some of them say they're not going to receive a dollar of this, but it's still going to impact how they live every single day.
I'm kind of one of those people that always thought there was no reason to be homeless.
But that became reality for Allison Prater.
Come to find out, it can happen to anybody.
Living on a fixed income, she became homeless nearly a year ago.
I moved to different spots on the street. It's a very difficult thing to go through.
She's one of several people hoping to benefit from the class action federal lawsuit against the city as she's losing the roof over her.
This homelessness situation is just so out of control everywhere. It's extremely bad here in Maui, even in what they call paradise. It was bad before the Lahaina fire. Now it's totally out of control. People are moving to different countries, moving back to the U.S., can't afford to live here. Oh, because the rich, they done bought up all the houses here in Maui. All in Hawaii, you know, Mark Zuckerberg is over in Kauai. They got their bunkers. Oprah got plenty of land here in Maui. Yeah, she got over 1,000 acres here in Maui. But it's so many people that are homeless and can't. They living on the beaches, sleeping in their cars, sleeping in tents. And y'all see it in the cities y'all in. Yep, this place is collapsing. This whole system is coming down. It needs to, because reform has to happen. And in order for it to reform to happen, spiritual reform, everything's got to be taken down. That's what we're saying. Y'all, let's keep these people in our prayers. I saw this and I wanted to report on it.
Over 20 people will not be sleeping in their home tonight after a fire in an apartment complex on Beach Boulevard damaged multiple units. Jacksonville Fire and Rescue says their units responded to the Magnolia Point Apartments around 12:30 this afternoon.
The complex is located just off of Beach Boulevard and Parental Home Road. News for Jax reporter Khalil Maykong joins us live from the complex. He spoke with one family. Khalil, they lost everything.
Yeah, Janice, that family.
People are losing everything. Everything. Fires, tornadoes, flooding, you know, and then we have the nerve. A lot of us, we complain about petty stuff when somebody else is in worse position than you. We need to be more gracious, more grateful, You know, that's what's really, this is an hour to be empathetic to what other people are going through. Shalom, Sister Risha. Good to see you. I got another one as I wind down, and I got some good words for you all here at the end of these Melchizedek News headlines. But I saw this as well. Remember, just in the last couple of days with all the flooding that was happening in Louisiana and Alabama, and kids were still in school. This is a good question. Why weren't kids like allowed to stay home with all this flooding, but you told them to stay at home during the eclipse? I mean, something's not adding up. It's a lot. A lot of things aren't adding up right now.
That flooding, parents and teachers in Orleans and Jefferson parishes are asking why schools weren't canceled yesterday,
especially after Jefferson Parish district leaders chose to let children out for Monday's solar eclipse. Eleanor Tabone has the story.
Once I got all of the tornado warnings on my phone around 10 to 12, then I began to get worried.
Dominique Barr's 13 and 11-year-old attend Andrew Wilson Charter School in New Orleans.
Once they left that element, they were no longer safe.
She says if students miss too many days, they run the risk of having to attend summer school. So because school wasn't cancelled, she sent them. This video was taken from the second floor of the school and what Dominique had to travel through to get to her kids.
I left out the house at 12:30. To go and get the children, and literally almost every street that I turned on was high water.
She says the water was up to her knees.
There were kids whose parents were walking out carrying them, little bitty babies who, if they would have walked in that water, would have been over their chest.
Yet Monday, we're dismissed for a solar eclipse.
Teachers in Jefferson Parish asking why wasn't school canceled after the severe weather predictions were released.
The end result was flooded streets, students and employees unable to leave the school sites, parents unable to reach their children, employees unable to tend to their own families, and then they had students stranded at schools waiting for someone to pick them up.
Sandra Howell with the Jefferson Federation of Teachers says school was cancelled for the eclipse, but not for a weather emergency.
My biggest fear.
School was cancelled for the eclipse, but not a weather emergency. Did you all see that footage? Parents was walking in water that was waist deep to pick up their kids from school. You see what I keep saying? Sister Chayah is the advocate of pulling your children out of these public schools. Pull your kids out of school. You, your family members, your neighbors, your friends, y'all get together and come up with your own homeschool program. They're not learning anything in these satanic schools anyway. They're being indoctrinated and brainwashed with lies. Pull your kids out. They're in danger. They got all kind of diseases, viruses, sickness going around. You can't trust these authorities. Nobody is ever accountable when something happens in the school. I just reported yesterday how a young lady was getting beat down at the school. No help. Kids getting killed at the schools. Pull your children out of these schools. You'll be okay. What are you feeling so guilty for? Because you've been brainwashed to think that the American school system is something that you need. It's time to wake up. We spent 12 years being indoctrinated with lies. And are our people any better off with the curriculum and the education system? You see, everything is falling and collapsing right in front of you. Get out of the denial. It's time to really face the music, people. That was ridiculous what we just saw. Those streets were completely flooded. They knew that bad weather was coming in. Yeah, because the school is getting money off each body in there. It's just like the prison system. You know, from the schools right into the prison system. They're making money off of bodies. I said it because that's what they're doing. School system is just like the prison system. It's time to wake up, brothers and sisters. Teach your children yourself. That way they can learn the things that you want to put into. You can give them a lot more knowledge than they are learning at these schools. Look at the teachers. Teachers out here having sex with the kids. Speaking of that, I got a headline regarding that.
And first up here at 10, a Tampa woman accused of posing as a homeschooled middle schooler over social media and molesting a student is now facing new charges. Four more victims have come forward accusing 23-year-old Alyssa Zinger of lewd and lascivious behavior. Fox 13's Jennifer Vagelis joins us now live in the newsroom. And Jennifer, how long has this been going on?
Yeah, Brianna, you may recall our coverage in November when Alyssa Zinger was first arrested after one boy between the ages of 12 and 15 came forward, stating she posed as a 14-year-old over Snapchat and lured them to engage in sexual acts.
Now, four more victims, all between 12 and 15 years old, have come forward, stating Zinger targeted them too. Zinger, who had been released on bond from her November arrest, was put in handcuffs again on Thursday, now facing 11 felonies, including lewd and lascivious battery and molestation, possession of child pornography, sexual cyber harassment, and more.
The charges are very serious.
Friday, ahead of Zinger's first appearance in court, state attorney Susie Lopez called the case every parent's worst nightmare.
She was preying upon these victims who believed that they were actually her age when in fact she's a grown-up.
In November, Zinger was...
She over here pretending to be a teenager, having sex with kids. What's going on in her mind? What's going on in her spirit? I told y'all, everybody that look like us ain't us. Because that's not normal whatsoever. What is it? Demonic. I got a follow-up to a story I brought to you all's attention just a couple of weeks ago with those two twin daughters, those teenage girls that ran away over there in Detroit where they've been found. Let me get a follow-up regarding that story, family. All praises to the Most High that they were found. But man, this is a long hill battle with this situation right here.
After a month of sleepless nights, the father of runaway twins is breathing a sigh of relief tonight now that they're back home. We first showed you the body cam video last night at 6. Allen Park police found the 14-year-old girls at a hotel with a man who allegedly used a stolen debit card. The owner of that card in Omaha, Nebraska, received a text about the charge and sparked the investigation that led to the twins' return. Tonight, their father is sharing his message to the strangers who saved the day. 7 Action News reporter Kimberly Craig.
Talk about a parent's agony. These girls were missing from their home here in Detroit for a month. Their father now so thankful to the strangers all the way in Nebraska who helped bring them home.
I really appreciate them.
George Ogden watching the story my colleague Faraz Javed did Wednesday with Megan McQueen and her daughter Abigail, two complete strangers living all the way in Nebraska who helped police locate his missing 14-year-old twin daughters.
What would you say to those women, that mother and daughter in Nebraska?
Y'all angels, pure angels. And it's not a lot of people that think as fast as they did.
Late Sunday night, Abigail received a text from her bank that her debit card had been used here in Michigan at this motel in Allen Park. Within minutes, Allen Park police arrived thinking they were just zeroing in on a man involved in a stolen debit card caper. But then Officer James Vandera quickly realized it was so much more when he recognized the runaway twins who had been missing for a month.
I know who you guys are. And I know who's looking for you. Okay?
Okay.
And we're going to have to solve that tonight.
I really appreciate the family for their quick thinking and actions. And also for Allen Park Police. Everybody was quick on their feet.
Absolutely.
And we need more of this these days.
It just turned out to be so much more than I thought. I thought it was just my debit card.
Who knows where they would have been? I mean, as a parent, I'd be sick. I don't even know what I would do.
George Ogden believes the man arrested at the motel.
That whole situation is just, yeah, talk about every parent's nightmare. We already know what's going on here. These older men out here preying on young women and men so you can put them out here to pimp them. Pimping and pandering. That's what this is really about. And these young, naive girls coming from these dysfunctional households, fathers, brothers, uncles, stay involved in your children's lives, especially your daughters, but all your children, your sons. Make a conscious effort to stay into the lives of your children's lives. Children, you know, even when maybe you ain't talked to them in a minute, maybe it's time to, you know, reconnect with them. Maybe you got like a scarred relationship because of things in the past. It's time to get involved with our children's lives. It's time for all of us to be mentors with the young people. You know, if you come across young folks, try to give them some game and some wisdom. Show them some love. Listen to them. Because that situation right there is just some young girls getting caught up with some older men that really all they thinking about is how they can make some money off of these bodies of these young women and exploit them. Human trafficking is at an all-time high. Why? Why is human trafficking around the world so big? It's because of families that are broken, men not being involved in their children's lives. Men, I'm calling on y'all. It's time for y'all to be accountable. It's time for some accountability. It's time for y'all to be the uncles, the fathers, the grandfathers that the Most High created y'all to be. We in that hour. It's never too late to make a change. Never too late to make a positive change. You heard it from Sistah Chayah. I got this last headline of the day before I bring some words of encouragement as we end the Melchizedek News Hour, which has been a little bit over an hour. But that's okay, because this is the Melchizedek News. We don't do anything traditional over here at the Melchizedek News. This is the news of the King of Kings, the Messiah. Yes, Motsah the Lamb, Christ, Yeshua, Yeshua, Yahusha. This is the channel that represents for him. So I got one more headline before we're out of here. And after this headline, I'm just going to read you some encouraging words. We're going to end it on this beautiful Sabbath with some encouraging words, you know, some encouraging words, because there's so much going on, especially in the Middle East. Woo, especially in the weather. This weekend gonna be something else, y'all. The next 7 days, family, get ready. I'm talking about put your big girl and your big boy drawers on, because it's about to get heated the next 7 days. All right, I got one more comment. Oh, I had a comment. What's that? Sistah Ruette in the live chat. We don't keep track of time. That's right, Sistah Ruette. We don't keep track of time. That's right. So it's never too late. That's what she's saying. It's never too late to make a positive change. Hallelujah. Thank you, sis. This is coming out of Florida, y'all. We're going to get a little kick out of this one. Drum roll in the live chat for this last Melchizedek News headline of the day. Should be quite entertaining. I try to end it on a bright note after looking at all that negativity and the things that's going on in the world. But, you know, we need to be aware of what's going on so that we may get our minds right and prepare and be able to face these things that are happening. Just because we want to bury our heads in the sand doesn't mean these things are going to go away. We are living in a dire time, a very critical time, and it's a time to repent and get baptized and give your life to the Most High. If you've been thinking about it and you've been putting it off and you've just been kind of just dabbling back and forth in evil and righteous, you've been going back and forth, evil, good, it's time to choose a side. That's the hour that we're in. Tomorrow's not promised to any of us. And there is the after this. It's called going into the spirit world. You're going to have to face your conscience. You're going to have to face the Most High with everything that you did in this flesh. All of us, we got to be accountable. Yeah, people, hell is a spiritual hell. Most High doesn't want to burn you with fire. You don't got to do that. You already going through hell here on this earth. There's a whole lot going on here. A lot of people in the living hell. So hell is a spiritual hell. And the Father wants you to go in peace when you leave this world. You know, it's a lot more to this. And something for you to think about. It's time to get your life right. It's time to clean up. But this is a light note in the headlines before we leave out of here.
On you this morning, you have to come and see this. Do you see this picture right here? That is what a Florida woman walked into in her kitchen. She found that big guy.
Yeah, nearly 8 foot long gator. It happened in Venice, Florida. The woman says she heard a bit of a rattling at the front door. She had a screen there, and she said the gator broke right through it and got inside.
Okay, so basically he just pushed on that and it just came open. From the time I first heard the door rattle to the time I came around the corner, it couldn't have been more than probably 10 or 15 seconds. He was already inside completely.
I mean, thank goodness she didn't have any pets, right? Mm-hmm. So that homeowner then called 911. Sarasota County deputies and FWC came, captured the animal. You see him taking it out right there. The homeowner says she thinks that the gator came from a pond, perhaps across the street. No one was injured, but there are some scratches on her cabinet. I've been saying all morning, if that happened to me, I would be out of here. If that were my neighbor, if that happened in my city, I would be.
Did y'all see how big that alligator was? That alligator better be glad he didn't end up in the wrong kitchen. Because, man, if he would have ended up in the kitchen of some Haitians, the wrong folks, they would have had some gator bites. Sister Roulette, they would have been having some deep fried gator bites. He almost ended up in the wrong kitchen. Woo! She was like, just come get him. Yeah, it wouldn't have been the same, boy. Yeah, yes, I'm telling you, and especially down there in the bayou, down there in the Florida and stuff. Woo! Gator bites, baby. All right, y'all. I got some inspiration before we leave out of here, because I don't want to leave y'all hanging today on this Shabbat on you know, negative note. We know it's many things going on in the news and many things we don't have control over. But what we do have control over is our salvation and our free will that the Most High has given all of us. Amen. He's given us free will to accept his invitation of eternal life. Really? Because, hey, this is such thing. I know a lot of people like, I don't believe none of these books and this stuff is true. It's true, sweetie. It's true. I love you. I'm your sister. I'm telling you, he's been so good to me. I love living for him. It's a beautiful thing to live for the Most High. You have such peace. You sleep good at night. Man, you're blessed. You don't be worried about money and all these material things. That's right. I'm storing up my treasure for things above. Because, you know, the word says, what does a man profit if he gains the whole world, but then he loses his soul? You're not profiting anything. So you might as well surrender and come on in. I got some inspiration as I leave out of here for all my brothers and sisters. I entitled it, Be Encouraged. Yes, family. What does we talk about before I leave? Be encouraged. And I just want to share this scripture with you. Thank you to my brothers and sisters that's always sharing scriptures with me. I love you all with real love, real respect. Hashtag RLRR. Sister Chaya loves you. This is coming from the Colburn Bible, and I just want to share it with you all today as we go into Sabbath. Some good thoughts coming from the Colburn Bible, chapter 15. And I'm reading from chapter 15, which states, the voice of God. That's right. That's why, as a matter of fact, my picture above, it says, be encouraging to all you meet. You never know who is having a hard day. Yeah, that's what it says. Be encouraging to all you meet. You never know who is having a hard day. You never know who's having a hard day. You think you're having a hard day. You think you're going through some things. Or somebody's probably going through worse than you. We just saw a fire that 23 people, 8 children were displaced. We just saw a number of tornadoes the next few days. There's more storms coming this weekend, more coming next week. People are losing their livelihoods, cars, businesses, storms, fires, flooding, windstorms, earthquakes. Just had that earthquake in Taiwan. Just had that earthquake. It was one in Taiwan. There was an earthquake scare in New Jersey. We're living in the hour. So be encouraging to all that you meet, because you really don't know who is having a hard time. So I'm going to start at 15 and 20. I've highlighted these particular precepts that I just want to share with you all because they're so encouraging. And this is the voice of God. Amen. The voice of God. Hallelujah. Share some words of encouragement to you today. Creation in no ways affects me any more than a man is affected by his shadow, okay? Or light by its reflection. As raindrops, waves, rivers, dew and mist are all forms of water, so is everything existing and knowable by man by various forms of the one substance. This substance has its origin in me. What? We're listening to the voice of God. This substance has its origin in me, but it is not me, okay? 15 and 21 says, I am the source of all things, okay? Not some things, all things. Supporting, but not being supported by them. Even as the mighty winds which sweep across the earth, find their rest in the tranquil vastness above. So all beings and all things have their rest in me. It is a power outflowing from me, which holds all things in stability and form. He says, I am God. 15 and 22 reads, they who devote their lives to my service must do more than love and worship me. What? Did you hear what he said, sisters and brothers? He says, they who devote their lives to my service must do more than love and worship me. For such service entails the elevation of mankind, the spreading of good, and the combating of evil. Let me go to my next. There I go. Sorry, family. I got to keep up with the screen. I'll start that over because it's so beautiful. They who devote their lives to my service must do more than love and worship me. For such service entails the elevation of mankind, the spreading of good, and the combating of evil. They must not only fight against the ungodly, but also overcome the wickedness welling up in their own thoughts. That's right. We got to control our thoughts because that's where everything starts, in our thoughts. They who love me desire the well-being of all men. Did you hear that? They who love me desire the well-being of all men. And their souls are filled with harmony and peace. Dearer to me than their love for me is the labor and tribulations of those who serve me. I am therein. I am never the God of inertia, but the God of effort. If you offer no more than deeds done in my service, or in conformity with my design, then you serve me adequately. That's right. He says, if you offer no more than your deeds done in my service or in conformity with my design, then you serve me adequately. That's right. It's your actions. Actions speak so much louder than words, sisters and brothers. In 15 and 23, the Most High says, however, too rarely do the ways of men conform to my plan, and the ranks of those who serve are too thin. Therefore, I shall call forth leaders. I shall call forth leaders from among men and send out the clarion cry to service. I shall seek out men who will serve me diligently and loyally. Look at that, diligently and loyally. They will be men of goodwill. And it says goodwill who are of friendly nature. Are you seeing that in people? They will be men of goodwill who are friendly, who are of a friendly nature. They will be kind and compassionate, men who can love deeply and truly. I love that. They will be kind and compassionate, not to some, but to all. Men who can love deeply and truly, whose steadfastness is the same in pleasure and affliction, who resolve remains equally unbroken in the sweet embrace of good fortune as under the harsh blows of misfortune. I will send men who are fair and just. Look at that. I will send men who are fair and just, proud and resolute. But these qualities mean nothing unless they have courage and resolution, fortitude, and tenacity. Amen. At 24, it says, I seek, listen, sisters and brothers, we're listening to the voice of God. I seek the man who is himself ever seeking, who seeks to unravel the riddle of life. One whose determination is strong, who detests wickedness and delights in the good, whose heart and inner vision reach out for enlightenment. His tranquility will remain unshaken under stress, and within his heart will be a haven of peace beyond the reach of excitement and anger. He will be a lover of wisdom and a seeker of truth. He who is wise, he who knows what to do, who remains calm, right? Who remains calm when others lose their self-control. He who is clear-headed under stress, who enjoys the challenge of the task that man is mine. He who labors uncomplaining, who disdains to satisfy deforming lusts, whose spirit remains the same under the temptations of honor, of honors, or the pressure of disgrace. He who is free from the shackles, you hear that? He who is free from the shackles of unworthy earthly attachments. That's right. Me and my brother have been talking about that the last few days, about that materialism. He who is free from the shackles of unworthy earthly attachments, who retains his balance under praise or blame, who can shoulder his own burdens, whose spirit is calm, silent, and strong under all circumstances. He who can bear the responsibilities of life and the obligations of love. That man is mine. I am the God of inspiration. I am the God of love. That's right, brothers and sisters. He says, I am the God of love. I am the God of inspiration. Are you inspired today, brothers and sisters, to do what's right in the eyes of the Most High? I pray that those words touch you. Oh, praises to the Most High for the reading of his word. Yes, all praises. Shabbat shalom, family, on this Melchizedek News. Yes, thank you for joining. Sorry, we went a little over. Thank you, Father. We love you. Shabbat shalom, family. I'll see you again in a few days. Shalom to all those in the live chat. Thank you for watching the Melchizedek News Hour. I'll see y'all again soon. Family. Shalom, shalom.